we take a global perspective. So first, I went to India and looked into stigma and discrimination in sex trafficking and discovered people who are helping survivors overcome their trauma. Every year, millions of children are sold into slavery, forced to offer their body for other people's profit.
Number of girls took from Bangladesh, Nepal, and West Bengal. There is major problem is behind the trafficking. Poverty is main problem, as well as illiteracy.
The girls are tricked with a promise of a better life and as a way out of poverty.
See, her sister-in-law said her to, I will give you good housekeeping job in Mumbai.
Have most of the girls been sold or betrayed by their family?
Yes. Like family, neighbours, relatives.
Meet Charumati. She was sold by her husband into prostitution to perform unspeakable acts to strangers in one of India's many red light districts.
My first client reached for my hand. I immediately pulled away and left the room. I demanded to know what was going on. My pimp said, he has paid his money, so you need to do your job. I don't want to do this kind of work, I replied, and I banged my head against the wall.
But she was forced to, and 12 years later, she's now living with HIV. But it's not just adults. Girls as young as 9 are sold into the slave trade.
First time the girls are coming here for the admission, they are very scared.
When you see the girls coming out of the rescue, they're so depressed, they're crying, and they have lost all faith on mankind.
But there are those working in the shadows to bring light to the darkness. Our cameras traveled into the heart of Mumbai's red light district to find a man who was working to give them rescue.
Is this a dangerous area to be?
Yes.
Why?
The pimps attack the customers, they attack the general public, they mug them.
But he braves the dark alleys to provide the girls rescue from prostitution and slavery.
I posed as a customer. It's the only way to get into the brothel. I get all the information and take it back to the office to plan a rescue.
The decoy works with the girls and comes up with a plan to get out. They are safe from this ordeal, but recovery is not an easy task.
When the girls try and reintegrate with the society, they face a lot of stigma and discrimination.
Girls like Kushi, who at 15 was sold into sex work, but now at 18 is being empowered and educated and helped with legal aid to get back home to Bangladesh. She's now on a mission to make sure that this doesn't happen to anybody else.
I just want to return to my village, find the man who sold me, bring him to justice and put him in jail. I had to go through this, but I hope no other girl does.
The girls that come here have many, many needs.
They are the hungry of affection, love.
And do they find affection and love?
Yeah.
How?
We will try to give them affection, love, give them moral support as well as counseling, psychological counseling, as well as social, psychosocial counseling, and how to bring her in mainstream of society.
How does society treat them?
Do you know about Indian culture? Indian culture.
I love that she said that. That is going in the film.
Cultural stigma aside, 68% of female sex trafficking victims meet the clinical diagnosis for post-traumatic stress disorder. But what struck me during this discovery was people's passion to help. Like when I met Amul, who has dedicated his life to teaching these girls karate.
I'm a part of this society, and why don't I come here and I teach them?
My dad always told me it's important to have money in life, but it's not necessary to have a lot of money. Whatever work you do, you must find peace in it. You must be able to sleep at night.
Through karate, He steals not only physical, but also emotional and spiritual strength too.
I'm a girl, but I'm not a helpless. I'm a strong.
Powerful.
Yeah, powerful woman.
It will get me ahead. My future will be brighter. When I go back to my village, I will teach my little brother and my brother's daughter. I will teach her karate and other lessons. I will tell her to learn these things and her future will be brighter too.
Wherever you live in the world, sex trafficking survivors need your help in your neighborhood. This form of human slavery exists in every country. Just go to fionadawson.com and you can learn how you can make a difference.